Hey everyone, welcome back to CNA to the channel. In today's video, we'll cover all the different ways you can put your Windows 10 computer to hibernation. Whether you're using a desktop or a laptop, we've got you covered. So let's dive right in. Introduction to Hibernate mode. Before we jump into the steps, let's quickly explain what Hibernate mode is and how to wake your computer once it's in hibernation. Hibernate mode is a power-saving state that saves the current session to your hard drive and then completely shuts down the computer. This allows you to power off your PC while preserving your work, so you can pick up right where you left off. It saves everything you're working on your hard drive, unlike sleep mode, which keeps data in RAM and powers down almost all hardware to conserve energy. When the computer enters hibernate mode, the power button or power indicator light typically turns off or blinks slowly. So, how do you wake your computer from hibernation? It's simple. On both desktops and laptops, you can press the power button to wake your computer from hibernation. Your computer should instantly wake up, and all your open programs will be exactly where you left them. Enable hibernate mode. Before starting the tutorial, we need to enable Hibernate mode in Windows 10. Hibernate is enabled by default on laptops, however, on some desktops, it must be enabled manually. To ensure that Hibernate is enabled, you can run this command on either your laptop or desktop. First, we need to open the command prompt with administrative privileges. Open the Start menu, type CMD, and select Run as Administrator. In the command prompt window, type the following command: power cfg space dash h space on. Press enter to execute the command. This will enable hibernate mode on your system. Once the command is executed successfully, you can close the command prompt window. Now that we've covered that, let's get into the various ways to put your Windows 10 computer into hibernation. Method 1. Using the power menu. The first method, and probably the most straightforward, is using the power menu. Please note that to use this method, you must have previously enabled hibernate mode, as explained earlier in the video, by using the power CFG command in command prompt. Open the Start menu, type Control Panel, and select it from the search results. Go to System and Security. Then under Power Options, click on Change what the power buttons do. Click on Change settings that are currently unavailable. Under Shutdown Settings, check the box next to Hibernate and click Save Changes. Once this is done, Hibernate will be added to the options in the Power menu. Go down to the Start button in the taskbar. Click it and then go to the Power icon. From here, you'll see the option to Hibernate. Click that, and your computer will enter hibernation mode. Simple, right? Method 2. Using keyboard shortcut. Next up is a handy keyboard shortcut. Please note that to use this method, you must have previously enabled hibernate mode, as explained earlier in the video, by using the power CFG command in command prompt. Additionally, you must have added Hibernate to the power menu using method 1. First, press the Windows X keys together on your keyboard to open the power user menu. Then, press U followed by H to quickly put your computer into hibernation in Windows 10. If you prefer using the mouse, right-click the Start button, choose Shutdown or Sign Out, and select Hibernate from the menu. The next keyboard shortcut is a bit more complex. First, press the Windows D keys together on your keyboard to minimize all windows and go to the desktop, or move your mouse to the lower right corner and click the Show Desktop icon. Now that you're on the Windows desktop screen, press Alt F4 together. This will bring up a menu with shutdown options. Press the up arrow key to select Hibernate, then press Enter. You can also perform this action with the mouse. These are quick and easy methods if you don't want to use the Start menu. Hibernate using keyboard shortcuts on some laptops or desktops. Here we'll use a simple trick to repurpose the sleep key and put the computer into hibernation. Certain laptops feature a dedicated sleep button or a function key combination. On this Asus laptop, the key combination is Fn plus F1, while on this Acer laptop, it's Fn plus F4. If your device has this feature, it's another simple way to put your computer into hibernation. Some desktop keyboards also come with a dedicated sleep button or key combination, making it easy to put your computer to sleep with a single press. If your device has a sleep button, you can modify its function to put the computer into hibernate mode via the control panel. To do this, go to control panel, then hardware and sound, and select power options. Click on choose what the power buttons do from the left menu. Under the power button section, change the setting for when I press the sleep button to hibernate, whether the device is plugged in or on battery. These options are usually set to sleep by default. If you have a desktop, you will see only one of these two options. Click Save Changes. After making this change, pressing the sleep shortcut keys on a laptop or the dedicated sleep button on a desktop keyboard will put your computer into hibernation. Method 3. Automatic hibernate settings in Power Options. Let's talk about setting your computer to hibernate automatically after a period of inactivity. This is super useful if you want to save power and don't want to worry about manually putting your computer into hibernation. Open the Start menu, type Control Panel and select it from the search results. Go to System and Security, then Power Options. Click on Change Plan Settings next to your selected power plan. On our computer, the balanced plan is selected and active. Click on Change Advanced Power Settings. In the Power Options dialog box, expand Sleep section, then expand Hibernate after. If you don't see this option, you must first enable Hibernate mode by following the instructions at the beginning of the tutorial using Command Prompt. Here you can set the time for your computer to automatically hibernate when plugged in and on battery. If you have a desktop, you will see one of these two options. Set your preferred time. Please note that you can also set the sleep time in the Power Options dialog box. In another tutorial, linked above and in the description, we go into detail about how to automatically hibernate your Windows 10 PC and what the ideal time settings for sleep and hibernate are. Click Apply, then OK. Your computer will enter hibernation after the specified time if it remains idle. Method 4. Change the power button's function. Here's another interesting method. Did you know you can make your computer hibernate just by pressing the physical power button? Open the Start menu, type Control Panel and select it from the search results. Go to System and Security or Hardware and Sound, then select Power Options. Click on Choose what the power buttons do from the left menu. Under the Power Button section, change the settings for when I press the power button to hibernate, whether the device is plugged in or on battery. If you have a desktop, you will see one of these two options. Click Save Changes. Now, whenever you press the power button on your PC or laptop, it will automatically enter hibernation mode. Method 5. Hibernate when closing the laptop lid. If you want your laptop to automatically hibernate when you close the lid, here's how. Open the Start menu, type Control Panel and select it from the search results. Go to System and Security or Hardware and Sound, then select Power Options. From the left-hand menu, click on Choose what closing the lid does. In the drop-down menu for When I close the lid, select Hibernate for both on battery and plugged-in options. Click Save Changes. Now, every time you close your laptop lid, it will automatically enter hibernation mode. This is a convenient way to quickly put your laptop into hibernation without needing to press any buttons. Method 6. Using PowerShell, CMD or Task Scheduler. If you're a fan of the command line, you can put your PC into hibernation using PowerShell or CMD. If you haven't enabled Hibernate as instructed earlier in the tutorial, first enable it using the following command. Open the Start menu, type CMD, and select Run as Administrator. In the command prompt window, type the following command: power CFG space dash H space on. Press Enter to execute the command. Now type or paste this command. The command is also available in the description. Press Enter and your computer will immediately enter hibernation mode. You can also save this command in a batch file and double-click it to put your computer into hibernation. To do this, open Notepad or another text editor. In the Notepad window, type or paste the following command. The command is also available in the description. Go to File, Save As. In the Save As type drop-down, select All Files. Name the file something like hibernate.bat and ensure the file extension is .bat. Save it in a location that's easy to access, example desktop. Double-click the hibernate.bat file and your computer will enter hibernation mode. You can also use Task Scheduler to set your computer to hibernate at a specific time. Here's how. Open the Start menu, type Task and select Task Scheduler from the search results. Click Create Basic Task from the Action menu or the Action panel on the right. Give your task a name, example Hibernate Computer. Select Trigger and set a specific time or recurring schedule. For this example, choose one time to run it once at a particular time. Under Action, choose Start a Program. Browse and select the .bat file you created in the previous step. Complete the setup and Task Scheduler will run the .bat file to hibernate your computer at the specified time. Note, if you create a hibernation schedule using Task Scheduler, make sure to disable automatic sleep and hibernation in Windows. And that's all for today's video. Now you know several ways to put your Windows 10 computer into hibernate mode, whether you're using shortcuts, the power menu, automatic settings, or even the command line. If this video helped you out, don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe for more tech tips. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.